Hello, Accounting 101 students. One of the main topics in Chapter 2 is the classified balance sheet. And we will go over how to prepare a classified balance sheet using the end of chapter practice exercise, question number 6. In this question, we are provided with a lot of different accounts, and we need to go through each of these accounts and identify which financial statement each account relates to. After we figure out which financial statement each account belongs to, we are going to go ahead and put the accounts in the appropriate order within the respective financial statements. So we're going to go ahead and get started with our accounts payable account, which is a current liability account on the balance sheet. And our accounts payable represents the amounts that we owe to our vendors and suppliers. Next, we have our accounts receivable, which is a current asset account, also on the balance sheet, representing the amounts that our customers owe us that we hope to receive within a year. Next, we have our accumulated depreciation account. Depreciation relates to the cost of the fixed assets, such as equipment, that is being allocated over the use of that equipment. So every year, a company will allocate some of that cost as a depreciation expense, which will be reported on the income statement. And as the equipment will be reported on the balance sheet, we want to keep track of how much of that cost has been allocated through this accumulated depreciation account. So accumulated depreciation account would be reported in the long-term assets section in the balance sheet. And it will belong in a subsection called property, plant, and equipment. And the accumulated depreciation account is special because it is a contra asset account. It actually reduces the amount of the equipment that's being reported. Next, we have cash, representing money in the bank. So this will be a current asset on the balance sheet. And then we're going to have common stock. And this is the amount that the investors have given to the business. And this is going to be reported in the equity section in our balance sheet. Now we have our cost of goods sold. And our cost of goods sold is going to be an expense in our income statement. And then we have our depreciation expense, which will also be in our income statement. And then we have our dividends account, which is a special account representing the amount that the company has paid to the investors or the creditors. And this dividends amount is only reported on the retained earnings statement. Next, we have our equipment, which is going to be a long-term asset because we're going to use our equipment over a number of years, maybe 5, 10, 15 years. So we're going to classify this as long-term. It will belong in the subcategory of property, plant, and equipment on the balance sheet. Our income tax expense will belong in the expense section in the income statement. So this represents the amount that is owed as well as the amount that is paid. And then we have our income taxes payable. That's the amount that we currently owe. So the amount that we currently owe will be a current liability on the balance sheet. Next, we have our insurance expense and our interest expense. Both of these are going to be expenses on the income statement. I'm color coding all of our expenses on the income statement in blue to make this a little bit easier for us to see. And then we have inventory. So inventory is the products that we are going to be selling to our customers. So the inventory is going to be a current asset on the balance sheet. And then we have land. Land is going to be a long-term asset because we're going to be using it for many years. Also on the balance sheet, and it will be within the subcategory of property, plant, and equipment. Next, we have mortgage payable. So mortgage payable is going to be a long-term liability on the balance sheet. And then we have notes payable. And notes payable is kind of interesting, because it's the amount of the loan from the bank. So if the amount that you owe within a year is provided, that portion is going to be a current liability. But also, you might have some portions or a loan that needs to be paid back in longer than a year. So that loan would be classified as a long-term liability. So with notes payable, you want to pay attention to when the loan needs to be paid back. Within a year, current liability. Longer than a year, long-term liability. Next, we have prepaid insurance. And prepaid insurance is when a company pays in advance for that insurance expense. So because we've paid for it in advance, it's going to be a current asset. On the balance sheet. Then we're given our beginning retained earnings. And our beginning retained earnings is going to be shown on the retained earnings statement. Then we have our salaries and wages expense. This represents all of the amounts that were earned and paid and payable to our employees for the whole year. So this will be an expense on the income statement versus the salaries and wages payable, which is the amount that is currently owed to our employees, but not yet paid. And we're going to pay those employees at the next pay date. So that's what makes it a current liability on the balance sheet. Then we have our sales revenue. So this represents the amount that we have sold of our product to our customers. Usually you're going to see either sales revenue or service revenue. And with sales revenue, this is going to provide us with the number or the quantity of the product sold times the selling price. So this will be the revenue reported on the income statement. And then we have our stock investments. And our stock investments can either be long-term or short-term. So if we're going to hold on to that investment less than a year, it will be classified as short-term. So therefore, it will be reported in our current assets section in our balance sheet. But if you had a long-term investment, it would be in the long-term assets section of the balance sheet. So this is a good place to start when you are starting any problem. And now we're going to go ahead and use these accounts and put together the income statement, retained earnings statement, and the classified balance sheet. In the income statement, we're going to prepare the statement for the year, and we're going to have our sections of revenue, expenses, and net income. Our revenues will have our sales revenue, and you will include the numbers that are provided in your problem. Then we're going to list our expenses. The cost of goods sold expense is always listed first. And then the remainder of the expenses are listed from largest to smallest for the purposes of Wiley homework, end of chapter practice, quizzes, and exams. And then we're going to have a subtotal for our total expenses. Next, we have our retained earnings statement, which is prepared for the same year. We start off with our beginning retained earnings for that year. We're going to add the net income. And you'll notice that your net income amount is coming straight from the income statement. Then you'll have a subtotal. You'll subtract out the dividends to end up with your ending retained earnings. Last, we have our classified balance sheet. And this is prepared as of a specific date. And the classified balance sheet needs to go in order of liquidity for assets and the order in which a liability needs to be paid back for the liability section. So for current assets, you should look at the illustrations in our textbook for the examples of the order. We start off with cash, then we have our stock investments, then we have our accounts receivable, followed by inventory and prepaid insurance. And remember, some companies might have additional accounts. Some companies might not have all of these accounts that are listed in this particular problem. Then we're going to have a subtotal for the total current assets. Then we're going to have our long-term assets, which will have a subcategory for property, plant, and equipment. For property, plant, and equipment, we first start off with land. Then we have our items that would be depreciated, such as equipment, or computers, or machinery, or furniture and fixtures. We expect to use those for a limited period of time versus land that will always exist. So we list our amount of land, and then we subtract our accumulated depreciation on that equipment. So you're gonna see that you need to take the equipment amount less the accumulated depreciation, and then you're going to get a subtotal. Then for your total property, plant, and equipment, you need to add up the land and the subtotal for the equipment, which is the net book value of the equipment. And then for the total assets, you're going to add up your total current assets and your total property, plant, and equipment. In our liabilities and equity section, we have our notes payable listed first, assuming that we need to pay back the notes payable at the beginning of the next year. Then we have our accounts payable, salaries and wages payable, and income taxes payable. So you will want to refer to the illustrations in our textbook for examples of the order in which payables should be reported. Then we'll have a subtotal for the total current liabilities. Then we're going to have our long-term liabilities. In this example, we only have mortgage payable. And then we'll need to add up our total current liabilities with our long-term liabilities to get our total liabilities. In the stockholders' equity section, we always have two things. We have our common stock and retained earnings. So our common stock is given to us in the data. Our retained earnings amount is the ending retained earnings from the retained earnings statement. And then we're going to need to get the total stockholders' equity. And after that, we're going to get our total liabilities and stockholders' equity. And you're going to notice that our amount for the total assets equals our amount for the total liabilities.